know, the reason why I got into coaching was because in my life, there were coaches who made a difference. And I wanted to be that coach who could make a difference in someone else's life and someone else's career.
So my name is Brandon Rich Sweet. I am the owner and coach at BRS High Performance Hockey. And I also offer private training, camps, clinics, lessons, as well as off-ice strength and conditioning. My coaching philosophy is founded upon the idea that there are four primary pillars behind hockey performance. Players who have the four pillars of performance, who are great athletes, are advanced in the five fundamental skills of hockey, who are able to react and multitask at game speed in response to a game stimulus with limited time and space, and players who are strong and well-conditioned are going to perform at the highest level in a game. So BRS High Performance Hockey offers a variety of different ways to help players improve. Number one is we're offering our Summer Skills Academy, which is an intensive training program where players are receiving 4 hours of training per week on the ice, as well as 2 hours of strength and conditioning. This goes for 8 weeks over the summer and is an intensive, comprehensive development game plan for players. BRS High Performance Hockey has developed a relationship with Moving Forward Performance and Fitness, which is a performance center in South Denver. We hire out our strength and conditioning program as part of the Summer Skills Academy to Moving Forward. And we feel that this is beneficial compared to a traditional model in that we're hiring exceptionally well-qualified, well-trained strength and conditioning professionals to carry out the strength and conditioning programming rather than just treating dry land as filler. It's an integral part of everything that we do. Players are really only as good as the physical tools that they bring to the ice. If players are slow, weak, not well-conditioned, and injury-prone, then they're going to have trouble executing the technical details on the ice.
This program is really developed to offer not only just a comprehensive approach, but a well thought out and well communicated program design between the skill developing on-ice coach and the off-ice side as well. Our ultimate goal is to help athletes perform better, to translate from the off-ice training to on-ice performance.
The relationship between on-ice training and off-ice development is clear in every single movement pattern you perform, whether it's being strong on a single leg or being able to put force into the surface you're playing on, whether it be an edge into the ice or planting your foot and changing direction on dry land. An individual works solely on skating, their ceiling is going to be very low.
What we can do off ice is continue to improve force development, power development, strength development, all those pieces that will then translate over to the already skilled skater who now can develop those skills at an even higher level.
The consistency and the methodology of our programming is going to allow you to walk away and enter this hockey season with an edge, a competitive edge, because you are stronger, faster, more explosive.
These athletes get through to the end of this camp and feel like the best hockey players they've ever felt like.
Our Summer Skills Academy is built on an academic model where players are working for about 1 to 2 hours every day over the course of the summer. I believe this improves development and improves performance better than a typical week-long day camp model where players are at the rink all day long and eventually reach a point of exhaustion and a point of saturation where they're not really developing. By coming in for an hour or two every day over the course of the summer, players are refreshed, focused, and able to perform the high quality reps necessary to improve their performance. Think about it like this. You don't go to an English camp or a math camp for a week in the summer to learn how to read and write or to learn how to multiply. In school, you work on it regularly over the course of the entire school year. And that is the way that players should treat their skill development as well. Players don't come to me because they want to get good at a C-cut drill. Players come to me because they want to make a team, because they want to reach their goals. And that is the end goal that we keep in mind with all of our programming, is how can we help players actually improve their performance, not just how can we train them to the drill. All of our programming is designed to train players to the game, which is where they're actually going to have to perform and where they're actually going to reach their goals, as opposed to training them to the drill. So when I say performance-oriented programming, what I really mean is that the end goal of everything that we do is improving on-ice, in-game hockey performance